we about to get ready to watch another member of the motherfucking FOT community, man. Shout out to my nigga Fargo. Fargo, be up in this thing, bro. Shout out to you for hitting 20K as well, my nigga. I see you over hitting 20K. We about to get ready to watch this YouTuber scammed his fans for over $1 million.
3 months ago.
OSN is a YouTuber that I never watched. I never been subbed to OSN. Never really fucked with any of his videos, but I never had a problem with OSN. Never had a problem with OSN. I don't got no problem with him. What I don't like is niggas that be scamming their subs and their viewers, bro. Real nigga shit, bro. Niggas that scam their subs and their viewers, bro. If you start a legitimate business and then your subs pay for something that you say costs X, Y, and Z, and it's a legitimate service, all right, bit. But just all out scamming niggas is nuts. Scamming niggas is crazy, bro. I could never try to really like scam the community. Like, I'm coming out with a bullshit ass NFT. Yo, look, a company hit me up to come out with a fucking NFT. What the fuck I look like coming out with an NFT? I said no, nigga. Cause I know that shit's a motherfucking scam. What the fuck? Who wants to trade sold NFT? Nigga, who am I? Nigga, you scam me out of 50 channel points. Oh, out of the channel points, nigga, I'm gonna scam you every time. Not every time, but shit, randomly. Scam them niggas, mods. Mods, scam them niggas. Me? Shit, you crazy. Nigga, I bought some NFTs. Them hoes is useless. That's a waste of money. A waste of money, man. But, yo, if you come out with your own clothing brand, you can charge whatever you want. It's your clothing brand. But scamming is crazy. So let's see what he did, man. Let's do it.
So I made a video revisiting the Cash Nasty and Oprahside beef from 2016 that started from accusations of Oprahside scamming two people for over $500 combined. The evidence in that situation was pretty much next to nothing other than a few DMs.
Oh, I remember this shit. Oh my God, I just remember that nigga OSN been scamming. I remember the reason why this beef started, and this is without me watching any videos. I'm going strictly off memory. OSN was playing a nigga in my team, right? It was like a wager. And OSN lost, and that nigga sent the nigga Australian dollars. He sent the nigga $500 in Australian money. I remember this shit. That's fucking nuts. Yo, my green screen is pissing me off all kind of ways, bro. Hold on, let me see if I can fix it. What is your black ass doing with Australian bucks? Damn, you know what? We gotta change the green. Oh my God. Damn, my shit ghetto, bro. What the fuck? Oh my God, it look like a fucking radio. What the fuck is so dark? Oh, it's that shit. Oh, no wonder my other ring light ain't on. Damn, I ain't gonna lie, one ring light kind of hit. Damn, I kind of like that lighting. Fuck it, leave it off. Y'all gonna have to deal with that. All right, that ain't too bad. Let's do it.
DMs and words.
Do you know how much effort you gotta go through to transfer your money over to Australian bucks and send it to a nigga? That's some scumbag shit.
Two people. So everything got brushed under the rug. Fast forward to today, Oprahside or OSN for sure
has
gotten
himself
into more controversy.
Turn the other ring light on. What the fuck wrong with my shit? This whole not even on him. Hold up. Bro, Elgato, what the fuck are you doing? Your dick invisible. Why is you looking at the middle of my pants? You on some nutty shit. nigga looking at the middle of my pants and shit. This nigga is being weird. That nigga on some other shit, boy. Hey, man, I don't know what you into, bro, and it's okay. I'm not into that. So you need to stop. Freak ass boy, bro. You need to leave. Hold on. Why is these bitches moving together, nigga? I don't want these hoes moving together. Okay, this is cool. All right, one more thing. Let me change my chroma key one more time. All right, we should be cool with that. Man, this shit's still ghetto. I don't give a fuck. Fuck it. We in this bitch.
Relating to scamming. After my video, I saw someone in the comments talk about him being a scammer. And you know, with me being a fed, I just
have— Yo, speaking of this, let me show y'all something, bro. Bro. Niggas get money and start doing crazy shit. Niggas get money and start doing crazy shit, bro. Fam. Fam. I promise y'all, bro. No matter how much money I get, I will not be on that weird, like, fashion shit, bro. Like, what is nigga shit at? Is this him? Hey, I promise y'all, real nigga shit. Shout out to OSN. I have no problem with OSN for real, bro. Like, I don't know him to have no problems with him at all. I'm just making an observation, all right? Fam, my nigga. What is this nigga doing, man? What the fuck is this nigga doing? Bro, some niggas say Paris changed this nigga or something. I don't know. Apparently, the nigga living in Paris. I don't fucking know. Niggas say drip. Look, even if you fuck with the fit and you think the fit drip, all right, bet. The fit ain't even the problem that I'm saying for the most part. Why is that nigga standing like those? Why is that nigga standing like those? Let me tell you what that, yo, this shit instantly remind me of this, bro. Bro, the nigga reminded me of this, bro. But is this nigga not hitting the Drewski pose? Like, bro, this nigga look dumb as hell, bro. But anyways, let's find out how this nigga scamming, bro. Because I've been meaning to watch this video. Only reason why I didn't watch is because I know I want to watch it with y'all. Let's do it.
Had to look into this. It's safe to say that this person wasn't wrong. This man really pulled a TJX6 on multiple people, and it's crazy. I've been looking at this for a good while to bring the truth to light. Hopefully his current supporters look at this video with an open mind and actually think about the person that you're giving your money to. Without further ado, Let's get into it. Clark Williams, better known online as Oberside, is a sports reaction YouTuber with millions of views since 2016. He launched his clothing brand Like Minds in 2019 with a pretty good reception. I personally like some of the designs, but I feel like it's overpriced.
Why doesn't dress like that pink sauce from TikTok?
Yo, y'all niggas that's buying that pink sauce is fucking crazy. We gotta talk about that shit too. Oh my God.
That pose is called the C-Town Origami Pose. Shout out to C-Town.
Crack rocks. That shit ain't called no motherfucking C-Town Origami, nigga. Don't give yourself no motherfucking poses and no names, nigga. Don't do that shit. All right, anyways, Yo, he said that OSN, this is clothes. I didn't know he dropped no clothing brand. You say you think it's overpriced? Honestly, I won't say that it is overpriced. I don't know the pricing. I don't know the pricing. But at the end of the day, I know this is not his main issue. But if a nigga charge some high-ass prices for their clothes, I mean, it is what it is. Like, if either y'all gonna buy it or y'all not gonna buy it, bro. Like, simple as that. His price is his price, bro. Somebody fucking with it. But just as long as you don't scam. That's my main thing. Just as long as you don't scam.
My opinion. I can't even really be mad at this because it's a YouTuber merch. OSN had a few more clothing drops in 2020 and 2021, but for this video, we're going to look into his most recent drops.
It was
in
hard,
October,
but he was taxing.
November of 2021,
hey, bro.
Which sold out completely. If you go to the Like Minds Instagram
cool.
account, you'll see a good amount of complaints of people not receiving the clothes they ordered since November, as well as other comments calling him a scammer and saying.
And this the problem. If you got a business that you are starting, you got to follow through. You got to follow through, bro. You can't fucking take no nigga's money. That nigga says, where's my shit? Hey, my nigga mad, bro. You can't take nigga's money, bro. These niggas that thought that your product was high, but they still paid for it. But for what they probably thought it was a fair price. They still paid for it. And your motherfucking ass scammed them.
And that they hope his business fails. Let me show you guys some evidence of people that have supported this brand that think that they really got scammed. All right, so the first person I have is my boy Drip. Shout out to my boy Drip. He showed me this screenshot from October of 2021. He showed me two screenshots. As you can see, if I click it, you can clearly see that he spent $130 on Like Minds. He got two hats and a shirt.
$35 hats. Okay. I've seen the price before. $60 shirt. Okay.
Crazy. Look at the prices. You think I'm about to really buy a $35 hat, which is not bad.
It's not
a $60 shirt is ridiculous. I'm gonna be honest.
I don't think so. I don't think so. Damn, my internet acting ass as fuck. A $60 tee is crazy. $60 tee is wild. How much y'all niggas paying for shirts? A $60 shirt? Oh no. Nah. I don't think that's bad, bro. Y'all niggas ain't like nigga charging $150 for a shirt. That's wild. 45 max. I now look when I come out with my merch. And shit like that, I'm not gonna be charging that.
Flame Blade 95
just think that's
subscribed.
Bad, bro. I guess I'm the odd man out. 60 kind of crazy, bro. I don't know. Maybe I'm the odd man out. Not that much. That's what I'm saying. Real shit. I don't think that this shit's that crazy, bro. If the shirt was $150, I'm like, oh damn, hold on, what the fuck going on, nigga? Come on, what the fuck you doing? But. I get hoodies for that price? Okay. Bro, my internet is fucking pissing me off.
Honest. But a $30 hat, $35 is kind of maybe pushing it, but it depends. But $30 for a hat is not bad for quality.
That's a fact.
But a $60 shirt is ridiculous. I ain't going to really get into that, but $130, he said he didn't get his stuff since October of 2021. That's crazy. That's ridiculous. And look at the screenshot. You can see another screenshot, October 30th. You see his order
October
number and everything. Free shipping.
Nuts.
You see Like Minds right here. It's ridiculous. Like, people didn't get their stuff, and it's getting crazy out here. It really is. All right, this next person I
Yo,
have
Theo!
Is my boy Matt Radian.
Appreciate you for
He's
subbing, my nigga.
Another side to the story. So, a lot of people, you didn't get your stuff
subscribed.
Yet. You might have to pay attention to this. This might have happened if you really were watching his videos or OSN's videos. This might have happened. I've done
subscribed.
My research, and I'm going to show you all later on as to why I think. That this might be
the... So, chat, what's the price of hoodies that y'all paying for? What's the price of hoodies? 64 shirt is crazy. What y'all paying for hoodies? $50 to $60? $60? $60 to $120? $60 to $70? $80 max? Okay, $100 max? Okay. All right, what about jeans? How much are y'all niggas paying for jeans? What's the most y'all get? What's the most y'all spend on some jeans? I don't wear jeans, what the fuck? $93,000, it's crazy, you ain't spending $3,000. $25 for jeans, what jeans are you wearing? $500, you ain't spending $5, you capping. $150 max. And honestly, the most I spend, I won't even say the most I spend on the shirt because I've spent more than that on the shirt, but like, I'm talking about like on some regular shit, bro, I could see a shirt being honestly $60, bro. I really can. Bro, like if you going into certain stores now, those are the prices of shit now. That's what it really is. For a hoodie, depending on the hoodie, I'll spend no more. I don't want to spend no more than $150 on a hoodie though. I ain't gonna lie. I don't want to spend no more than $150 on a hoodie. But I've seen more expensive hoodies, but I'm just not gonna buy them. I'm just not gonna buy them. Jeans, I bought $100 pair of jeans before. And it's not even no flexing shit, bro. Like, I don't come on stream to flex on y'all, nothing like that. I'm just honestly having an honest conversation, bro. The price of clothes ain't cheap no more. That shit is not cheap. Bro, if you go into any one of these regular stores that's not a H&M, that's not a Forever 21, them shits is not cheap no more, bro. Them niggas is, bro, you want some fire ass jeans, bro. Them bitches expensive. Levi's still gonna be the basically same price, but Levi's is more expensive than what it used to be. Clothes is not cheap no more, bro. I'm not even capping. You have to go to the outlet stores. Oh, that's a fact. Yo, it's workarounds. You can go to outlet stores. You can wait for shit. Nah, $100 jeans, bro. You tripping? I'm gonna be honest. I do not regret buying them jeans at all. I don't regret buying them jeans at all. Hey, I got some purple jeans. Those were a gift. Them jeans good as shit. But yo, I got some jeans. They call Art of Chaos. They some all black jeans. Them motherfuckers is fire. I don't regret buying them jeans at all. And they're a good quality pair of jeans. But for $100, I'm going to wear them bitches for a minute. I promise you I will.
So he said he bought plenty of like mods from OSN and he has a great brand. He bought two of his drops and a piece from his third drop.
I'm not shopping on the budget. That's kept.
And he came into one of his videos after the drop.
I've been stealing jeans.
Super furious and cranky the whole reaction. I actually went to his channel crazy. And looked back around that time, and he might be right. Like, I don't think I found the exact reaction, but there was a time where he came in the drop. He was hype. He was happy about the drop and all the success and all that stuff about it. Because remember, he dropped a regular drop and he had a deluxe drop where he dropped like some pants or something.
I wear my mom's jeans. You need to leave her clothes alone.
Video all hype and stuff, and I think a few videos later he was kind of irritated about something, tired, whatever he was going through, whatever, but it was different, you know what I mean? It wasn't the same OSN.
Last week everything starts going out on Monday. Listen, I wanted everything to go out last week, and it pisses me off that it didn't go out this week, because it makes me look less credible. But I swear to you, all my life, I wasn't lying when I told you I bought the ship before. It's a problem with the company that I use that ships it out. I don't know. They're like having some sorting problem or whatever. It hasn't been able to go out this week. It's annoying me. It should. It's all there. It's done. It's ready to go. It's pissing me off, too. It's going to go out next week. I promise you that. I don't know. But
nigga said next week, these niggas ain't get their clothes in October. My God.
Either way, it's still better than like in the past when it was a long time. It was like a month. You know what I'm saying? So either way, it's better. But I know you guys are like, yo, what's the stuff? You said it was going to be. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. I said that. I really wanted it to be that. That's what it should have been. It's a problem with my shipping company, but they're going to figure it out and everything's going to go out starting Monday.
And in that same video, he says OSN mentioned that a huge bundle of his clothes got lost. A truck or something lost it and it was meant to be shipped. And Matt didn't get refunded, but he doesn't think that it was by ill intent. So I don't know. It's a few people that might have that case, a few people that might say he scammed or whatever. But me, I'm be honest, from the facts that I'm getting presented, I honestly think.
Y'all be making the corniest niggas famous, the corniest. I mean, I won't say that nobody made that nigga famous. The nigga put in enough work at the right time to get popping. OSN did right shit. He was hopping onto my team shit. He went and did the reactions and all that shit. He got popping at the right time, honestly. And it's not the fans' fault. You can't put that on them because they didn't know who this nigga really was. The money turned him into what he actually is, honestly. A nigga that's fucking scamming. Like, a nigga that ain't got no problem taking other people's money from what we're seeing, honestly. Yeah, bro, you can't blame niggas for that, bro. Oh, yo, most subscribers of YouTubers don't know anything about YouTubers. All they know is they're putting out funny videos that I like. Especially if them niggas don't live stream. I'm being 100. When a YouTuber and content creator live streams, you get to know more about them because, bro, y'all done heard about my brother punch me in the motherfucking nuts with a John Cena chain. It's y'all are able to get more of me because I'm watching this video. I might randomly go off and tell y'all a little bit about my life. In a YouTube video, I might not never do that. It's not niggas' fault.
That he might have scammed some of y'all, I'm be honest. Okay, I can understand it, right? It's another side to the story, and I get it. A huge bundle of your clothes got messed up, or the orders got messed up, whatever. But to not update anybody after, at least like give an update, and it's been like, what, 7 months now?
Yeah, that's nuts.
Come on. You ain't give an update or nothing? Come on, bro. You ran off. You know you ran off.
If you still waiting on clothes for 7 months, nigga, get them niggas they money back. Yo, you are paid, nigga. You made it. Your subscribers are hardworking people, my nigga, and they are patronizing your business, and you ain't get them their money, bro. They need that shit. They need the money or they need their clothes. Point blank, period, nigga. Don't make them wait for their shit.
As for all the people that have gotten scammed, I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry that really happened to you, but I really suggest if you didn't by now, go to your bank and request a refund.
Absolutely.
If you didn't get your stuff, you can clearly show them that you didn't get your stuff yet. You can show.
Yo, Flocko! Just for the big 13 months, gang. Yep,
big 13. Time is flying. I done had a kid and your content has gotten me through a lot. I appreciate you, big dog.
Real
big
shit,
support,
man.
Keep doing your thing.
Hey, Flocko, bro, you already know, man. You so crazy love and crazy support, bro. I really appreciate that, bro. Thank you.
That you didn't even have a tracking number for it. Whoever didn't get their stuff. But if you got your stuff and you didn't get everything, I would still contact my bank too. Just get a refund. Absolutely. You know, charge that thing back, because at this point I don't feel like he's gonna send all these people his money back. That's all I have to say to y'all about the clothing brand. This man is really out here buying different types of stuff, different types of designer, all this other stuff, and you got people in your comments.
You over here in Paris. Oh shit, wrong shit. I'm something old shit. You over, thank God that nothing crazy popped up. You over here in Paris. Standing, where that shit at? I ain't got no kids, nigga. That nigga in Paris standing crazy as hell while niggas ain't got their jewelry. Why niggas ain't got their, ain't got their motherfucking clothes, bro. Look at this nigga. Carefree. You have two? Who got two? Fuck, you got two kids, nigga? Hey, congrats, my boy. I got three. Hey, man, how many kids y'all niggas got? Boy, like, look at this nigga in Paris living the time of his life, scamming this shit out of these niggas, bro. Jay Wills, you ain't got no five motherfucking kids. You ain't got no goddamn five kids, bro. I have one, a streamer named Trey Sold. Okay, let's go on ahead and,
telling you that you a scammer and to send them their clothes, and you sitting there flexing on the gram and stuff like that. And another thing that I really have to show y'all before I really get to the next segment.
I should have one, but I wear condoms. Hey, man, listen. Hey, my boys, let me tell y'all one thing, man. If y'all listen to me, please, y'all going out there, man, wear a jacket, man. Wear a jacket, because them scares is nothing to play with. Man, put some clothes on, man. Them boys ain't nothing to play with, man. I'm trying to tell y'all, y'all better stop. Y'all better stop. No, I don't. Y'all better stop. Hey, them scares, nigga can't eat. Nigga being that motherfucker. That nigga be going through it. Love me. Unconditionally. Boy. You never leave me. You being that motherfucker like, God damn. I'll have a confession. You say you late? You said you late? How many days? Say it ain't so. Are you sure he's just not a little bit like? Hey, man, I'm gonna tell y'all, boy, real shit. That shit not funny. Real shit, I'm keeping it a stack of y'all, boy. Y'all niggas need to wrap it up, man.
Of this video is he went live on the Like Minds account by accident.
Trey, you taking male birth control when it drop? Chat, what about y'all?
Man, depending on the side effects. Yeah, nigga. What did the motherfucker at, Boy, if the side effects is minimal, let me tell you what, my boy. Hey, they can sponsor me. You hear me? D Savage, tell them niggas. I'ma pop this pill. Oh my God. Listen, now if the side effects is crazy, if they giving niggas like male titties and shit, I can't get it, bro.
What if side effects make you lactate? You still down?
The side effects make you lactate? Fuck no, nigga walking around leaking and shit. Hell no. Hell, I'm a virgin anyway. I don't even participate in none of that. Huh? Fuck no. Nigga walking around leaky faucet. Fuck is he talking about? Sword Mike? Hey, I ain't fucking with none of that. No. Nigga walking around the middle of your pants ruined. Nah, you got me fucked up. Fuck that shit, nigga. Hey, I'm walking down here. I'm walking in the Galleria. Nigga looking at me like, girl, that nigga done pissed himself. You got me fucked up, bro. Anyways, let's go back.
Next segment of this video is he went live on the Like Minds account by accident when he was in Paris. Recently he went to Paris. He went to Paris with the money that he got from y'all that he never sent y'all clothes. He went to Paris with it. The NBA season is over. You know he has a new Twitter because his old Twitter got suspended, right? He made a tweet that said something along the lines of, y'all know what I'm gonna do at the end of the season, or you know what time it is at the end of the season. I only have one thing left to do. In the comments is people thinking that they're going to get their stuff shipped season four or the, you know, season four of the
scam
new
us
clothes,
again.
whatever. And it turns out it was a trip to Paris. So he went live on his IG account or on the Like Minds account.
Them niggas.
And was like, oh, I was wondering why all these people wasn't on a live or whatever. Damn, it's the wrong account. Hops off the live, hops on his main account and starts flexing all this other stuff that he's in Paris. And you see in the comments, I screen recorded it. You see in the comments, people call him a scammer, all this
other
stuff.
That's crazy.
Oh, I'm on the wrong account. I'm like, what?
That's crazy.
How we feeling? Hey, can I talk to y'all real quick?
Wrong account, boy. You know how mad I'll be, boy. This nigga, I ain't get my shit. I ain't get my merch, and you got these VVS diamonds in your motherfucking mouth. You in Paris, earrings blinging. I'm mad as shit, nigga. You got these motherfucking goofy ass cop glasses. Mad as hell, this nigga. Yo, where my merch
when
at,
I told y'all niggas the season over, you hold on, Dizzo. So when I told y'all niggas the season's over, you know what's next. I didn't like the responses y'all gave me. Y'all gonna sit out here and act like I didn't teach all you niggas how to cap.
Where we at right now?
He's Steph Curry.
What do you mean how to cap?
Steph Curry.
Where we at? Hey, I swear to God on my mom, I swear to God, this is the weakest fit you gonna see me in the whole time I'm out here. So I just wanted to let y'all know I didn't appreciate y'all niggas acting like I'm not that boy. Like y'all don't know who the fuck I am. Pootie DMing me and shit like, oh, are you really out there? Like, Pootie, do you have any idea how much money I have? Like,
nigga, where them niggas merch at? This nigga Chad, I'm telling you. I'm telling you. But yo, hey, fans didn't hit this nigga up. Hey, boy, hey, but hell nah, you ain't going to Paris, but hell nah. Nigga, we know you got enough money to go to Paris. Where them niggas' money at? Trey finna do the same shit, though? I swear to God, listen, look. I ain't gonna lie. I got a few things I'm starting up. Anything that I do is legit, and I will not scam nobody, nigga. If you buy something from me, you getting your money back, nigga. On God. On God, nigga. Well, now you getting your money back. Yo, you getting your shit. That's nuts. This nigga in Paris, that nigga pulled his head. Nigga, I ain't got my shirt.
Do y'all niggas not know who I am? Sometimes you, see, that's the problem. Sometimes you gotta reintroduce yourself to niggas. Sometimes niggas forget who you are. They forgot who I was. Nigga? Y'all must have forgot who I was.
It's crazy how you really neglect that account.
Yeah, he really
and you don't even follow. When you don't even follow yourself on the account, like when you're not dropping clothes, you really don't care about the account.
I mean, so this nigga love
haven't dropped clothes in 7 months. Seven. That's a lot of months for a no clothing drop. It's the summertime.
Oh God, that nigga NFT scam.
Last drop, I think season 3. He was hinting at something big that was gonna go down or whatever, based on the amount of money that he made from the clothing brand and stuff like that, and saying that people who supported Extra was gonna get something special, and said that it wasn't clothes. If you really like thought about it, like what was popping around that time?
He got a Patreon to scam more. This nigga got a fucking Patreon. Send me this nigga Patreon. What the fuck? NFTs is a scam in general. Listen, NFTs is down. I am not finna argue for them. If you think them bitches is a scam, them bitches is a scam. All right, but. Anyways, bro, I don't get the point of starting something and then quickly just grabbing the cash and dipping. If niggas is showing you that they willing to buy your merch, why not ship them niggas they fucking merch? And then if they like it enough, they can become repeat customers. But you so short-sighted, you just want to get a quick, well, what you scamming niggas out of, 30, 40 bands? Was it worth it? In my opinion, it ain't, bro.
NFTs. This project turned out to be an NFT project called Danger Rangers.
20 people that bought season 3 this week and last week. They will be getting something in about 2 weeks from me. No, it's not close. No, it's not a follow. It's something I've been working on. It's my top secret. It's my top secret project. And 20 people will be chosen. It's gonna be worth a lot of money. I don't want to say it too much. I don't want to give too much away. More info will be coming on that in the following weeks. Every single day is about to get crazy. But listen, I will be choosing 20 people. If you can, please go support your boy. It would mean the world to me. I would really, really, really appreciate it. There's no time that I think that I've ever dropped.
Trey, my girl, 8 weeks. We just got the ultrasounds last week. Gotta send you them, guys, and watch the Black Panther trailer on stream. And when we getting that 2K11 VOD.
Hey, I think I might, let me see. I might unlisten to the 2K11 VOD a little early. Because I was supposed to send Biggie some footage and I've been crazy busy. I think I might unlisten 2K11 VOD real soon. That's for the 450 in the motherfucking chat, man. Yo, Wolf, man. Congrats, man. Hey, bro, we got a lot of people in the community having kids, man. Yo, those are blessings. I was talking shit about the scares, but see, yo, when it's your time, them blessings, bro. But we already watched the Black Panther trailer as well. All right, man, this nigga here is just talking and chatting, bro. I'm so tired of NFT scams. I'm tired of seeing and hearing about niggas scamming niggas through NFTs, bro. Boy. Soulja Boy done scammed a nigga. Mayweather done scammed a nigga. OSN done scammed a nigga. De'Aaron Fox done scammed a nigga. Shit, nigga. I got scammed by Stan Lee and the nigga ain't even here. How about a motherfucking Stan Lee NFT? Them bitches ain't even, no, hey, ain't nobody even buying them bitches. I done lost my money. I got scammed by Stan Lee. Nigga, well, nigga was on his Twitter account tweeting this shit. Chakra the Invincible. Bitch, Chakra is dead. Ain't nobody buying no Chakra. That nigga wasn't too invincible. That nigga wasn't too invincible. Nigga, dead as hell. I got scammed by Trey. Yo, Juice, man, listen, bro. Juice. Juice, hold on, Juice. Talk to me. Wait a minute, Juice. Wait. Juice. Listen. I still have the NFT in the account. I've been completely transparent, Juice. I thought that motherfucker was gonna blow. I'm gonna be honest, bro. I thought it was gonna blow, Juice. I thought it was. But I'm not gonna sell until that bitch blow. This is just, listen, man. Look, bro. I be looking, yo. Niggas buying them bitches $1,500. Oh. I know that bitch is gonna blow, Juice. Yo, money. Thanks for giving my nigga Juice man a motherfucking sub, bro. It doubled and we didn't sell. I know, bro. We got greedy. We should have took our bag. We should have made our little money and got up out of there. I thought that bitch is gonna be the next goddamn Bored Ape. Now them bitches worth $1,500. We down 90%, man. I'm sick, man. Real nigga sold Dogecoin before it crashed. I did. I sold my Doge. I made a cooler bag off Doge. Made a cool bag off Doge. Made a cool bag off GameStop. Made a cool bag off AMC. And then I proceeded to lose all that bag on NFTs. That shit was crazy. I'm rich. I'm not rich at all, bro. I promise you I'm not rich.
For dumbass. Right now, like I really, really am trying to make a difference. So if you can, please help your boy out. The support from you guys has been amazing. I'm getting ready to drop some.
Hey, NBA Top Shots. A lot of niggas lost money on that. I didn't. Yo, NBA Top Shots, now that shit is fucking trash. Them niggas, yo, they did not expand themselves enough. They did not expand enough, bro. Top Shots ass now. But I definitely made money from that shit. I made money from it. All right, let's go back.
Can please help your boy out. The support from you guys has been amazing. I'm getting ready to drop this project. Hopefully on Monday.
What this nigga is a scam.
So I just feel really good. I can't wait to tell you guys what I've been working on. It's really gonna
look
change.
Look what he pushing to his niggas,
so
bro.
So much. And I'm just so excited.
He's not pushing legitimate businesses where he providing a service. This nigga is, he hyping the fuck out of this NFT. And I guarantee you, they finna rug pull the fuck out this shit, bro. He sound like Trey right now? Not at all, bro. Bro, one thing about me, please don't joke and call me no scammer, bro. Cause like, I can't do that. I can't scam niggas, bro. If I'm behind something, it's legit businesses. Nah, I can't do it. I'm done with NFTs, bro. Yeah, Juice, I'm gonna be honest, man. I'm done for the most part, bro. I'm done. All the NFTs that I have, I'm gonna try to see if them bitches come back. If not, them hoes is finished. I'm not selling nothing until it goes up. If it don't go up, we all owe a piece of nothing. I'm done with NFTs right now, bro. But there is money still to be made in NFTs. I'm going to be 100. There's money to be made. I just don't want to do the research to find where the money is to be made. That's my main problem. I don't want to go look for that shit. Fuck that shit.
Wait to start talking about it. I think it's my best idea yet.
That's me with crypto? Oh, I'm down in crypto. But okay, let's let everybody down. I'm not worried about being down in crypto. I'm gonna be honest. I'm not worried.
I got some crazy stuff to tell y'all. Like I said, I have something coming.
Look at this nigga hyping this shit.
In those of you that supported extra, I think y'all might get a little bit extra too. You know what I'm saying? So copying those clothes might have just made you money somehow. Anyway, I'll lie. I don't know if you guys have heard me, but I said before in previous videos that I really have this master plan to help make some serious
bro,
impact on the
this
world.
Nigga was gassing his fucking NFT.
And I plan on doing that in the next 30 days. This is not a plan. It's going to take a year. I plan on doing this in 30 days.
All money. Appreciate you giving Big Div a sub. Big Div, fuck you in your portfolio, nigga. Big Div, how much you down in your how much you down in stocks right now, my boy? Stocks ain't been too good, man.
Continue this without the help of you guys. I'll talk more about it in the future, but this is very important to me. I have a really important plan. It's the reason that I've been so excited and happy and feeling good every day is because God came to me and I came up with a really good idea and a really good plan for something. So yeah.
How much am I down?
I'm extremely excited.
I opened up 1%. I think I'm I think in one of my portfolios, I see what percent I'm down in my stocks. Overall, I am down. Hold on, put my password in. Down 20%. And in this portfolio, I own Tesla, AMD, NVIDIA, Google, Roblox. Oh, that Roblox fucked me up. Honestly, I don't own bad stocks, though. I might. This shit'll come back. I'm cool. Listen, bro. I do not invest anything that I can't lose. That's the main thing about investing. Yo, do not invest anything that you can't lose, bro. Also at the same time too, if I hold long term, those are good companies. Google ain't going nowhere. Tesla ain't going nowhere. NVIDIA ain't going nowhere. AMD ain't going nowhere. Also, Roblox still going Roblox. That shit ain't going nowhere, bro. So being down 20% right now, I'm okay. I promise you I'm okay.
That likes NFTs or enthusiasts into this project by adding that it was for a good cause and promised to pledge $500,000 to a community selected charity supporting endangered species. He even tried to get Gary.
Wait, go back.
I'm extremely excited.
OSN hooked everybody that likes NFTs or enthusiasts.
It's a bear market. It's a fact.
By adding that it was for a good cause and promised to pledge $500,000.
Let me look this Twitter up. This nigga a scammer. That's crazy. OSN, what it is, bro. It's a Danger Ranger. Boy, look at this shit. Them niggas ain't tweet since fucking January, bro. Bro, these niggas have not tweeted since January, y'all. What a fucking rug pull. The wrong shit. These niggas ain't tweeted since January, bro. Why is it not showing? What the fuck? Oh. Bro. Nigga danced and scammed. Nigga dancing with y'all bad. What y'all gonna do about it, bro? That shit is crazy. Dancing is what I do. Scamming is what he do. That nigga rug pulled them niggas, bro. That shit is crazy.
To a community selected charity supporting endangered species. He even tried to get Gary V to support this project on Twitter under the hashtag Save Our Species. The price to mint, meaning the price to buy this NFT, was 0.8 Ethereum, which is about $90 for everyone unless you had.
That's $90 now. What was Ethereum at in January? Ethereum price, January. Let me look at this chart. Back in January, Ethereum, this is January the 22nd. Okay. Damn, nigga. All right, get my calculator. All right, 27. times. Point. Damn, nigga, what a point at, bitch. It cost these niggas $156 if my math is correct. $157 to mint this. He scammed niggas for $157.
Some type of exclusive discount. On January 24th, the same day that the NFT dropped, he announced that he'll be capping the supply of NFTs at 5,000 and that they were more than halfway sold out. Stay with me.
What was the numbers? I got you. Okay. So in around January the 22nd, Ethereum was going for $2,615.25.
While I do this math, I'm not really a mathematical person, so I'll break it down in the simplest terms for people just like me, because I really don't like math like that, I'll be honest. I'm not a stupid person, I ain't gonna lie, but I really don't get into the math equations and stuff like that, but just, you know.
It's cool, bro. Look, hey, everybody got their strengths and weaknesses, bro. Everybody got their strengths and weaknesses. You good, guy.
Bear with me, you know, as I go through this. He said that they were capping it at 5,000 and that they were more than halfway sold out, so that
motherfuckers spent 156 but won't send $5 to African people that would need it. I mean, Jamaica, yeah, I understand where you're coming from in theory, and yes, we would love the people to be spending and sending more money over to countries, especially to Africa, that need those resources. But at the same time, these niggas was not spending $156 just thinking that, oh shit, I might not ever get these back. These niggas was investing this, and they were investing this, hoping that this $156 turned into $250, turned into $500, $1,000. Like, this shit is in January. Nigga, January was when niggas was buying Rumble, or no, when niggas was buying Bored Apes for fucking $56,000. Niggas buying CryptoPunks. You seeing niggas selling CryptoPunks for $125 million. A bunch of niggas was trying to get a piece of the pie, bro. These were just regular people trying to get bags, bro, honestly.
That means they sold about 3,000.
Yo, so Juice, you see it, bro.
A little bit over 2,500, you're getting into the 3,000 range, so I might as well just round that up to 3,000. After about 3,000 people bought this NFT for 0.8 Ethereum, that equates to 240 Ethereum made from all those sales. So 240 Ethereum was made in total. The crypto market has dipped like crazy in the past few months or so, but if you go back to late January to early February, the price of one Ethereum was worth about $3,000. So if you take the 240 Ethereum that he made from this project and multiply it by 3,000, the total is $720,000. That's a lot of money. Some of you are probably wondering why I said February. This is the month that the rug pulling went down. The Danger Ranger project was not going in a good direction, as there was no real growth and the value of each NFT was going down. The floor price right now is $1 as we speak, meaning the lowest price.
What you mean, with the 15.25? That's how much it was.
OSN had to buy about 60 of his own NFTs to show people on the outside that, oh my God, my community is just going crazy. They're buying up the stuff.
Let me go to OpenSea. I want to see what this NFT doing.
561 bread just subscribed.
Yo, 561. Welcome to the motherfucking gang, man. I hope you enjoy your stay, gang. Real shit. I appreciate you for the sub, bro. Thank you, bro. That's how much he ran off with. This nigga is sick. Danger Ranger. All right, here we are on OpenSea. Yo, iPod! Appreciate you for the big raid, bro. Thank you, my G. Thank you, gang. Hey, Ted, do me a favor, man. Make sure that, hey, do me a favor. Somebody spam iPod link in here. Go to iPod Twitch and follow my nigga. Go to iPod Twitch and follow my nigga, bro. Start supporting, you know, all of the sale. That's my dog, man. All right, I ain't been on OpenSea in a while. Where do I go to OpenSea to see the shit that's selling? First of all, this shit is going for 0.1 ETH. 0.01 ETH. This shit is dead. This shit is dead. Boy, this shit is dead. And the NFT look ass, too. I'm going to be honest, but shit, that don't matter. I didn't see ass NFTs. Oh, here we go. Activity. A nigga sold one 6 days ago for $15. A nigga bought one the other day for $1.15. Lord Jesus. This is a dead project. I will never start an NFT. You hear me? I will never, you can clip this. I will never start an NFT. Cause I don't want to be committed to making it work. Yo, niggas thought the NFTs was just bags and you could just do this and people buy them. No, niggas are expecting shit. That's why the projects that are actually moving and niggas making money, yo, people are getting things for holding them. This nigga OSN ran off with a bag. My God. Matter of fact, hold on. He tweaked out. It's OpenSea, nigga. We can see how much niggas really paid for these bitches. Is this the price at the time? I think so. One nigga just paid $139. I seen you. I know you mad. Yeah, here go them prices. He going down. Oh, hold on. Can I do a custom range? All time. Boy, niggas is paying in the hundreds. It's 93, 91, 77, 90, 94, 107, 120. 116. Niggas was spending, this shit went from $100-something to being worth a fucking $1.50. What a scam. Look who they buying them from. Clark OSN. A nigga bought it for him for $139. Boy, this nigga is a
James
scammer.
Scores 1,234 just subscribed.
All right, from two. So this is niggas that's buying shit from him. Right, am I reading this wrong? Did he buy these? I can't remember if I'm reading this right. Wait, let me go back to the other page. All right. W direct to consumer. No, this is not a W, my boy. He listed this shit for sale. It expired. He ain't getting no money from this. He ain't been active on this shit in 5 months. Hey, that's a plus to him because if this nigga was still moving and grooving on this motherfucker, that'd be crazy. But this nigga, he scammed the fuck out of these niggas, bro. Look at this shit. Boy, he scammed them niggas, bro. $100-something to fucking 50 cents. Look, y'all see these numbers. 90s, 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 100. Let's go back home, go up, go down one. Look at these numbers. $1, $7, $1, $15, $31. Who the fuck bought this shit for $31 3 months ago? My God. Anyways, back to the video.
And that was far from the case. I don't really have crazy knowledge in NFTs or crypto itself, but a good example for trying to sell an NFT with very low value will be trying to sell some very old used Jordans.
That's a cap. That's cap. That's cap. That's cap. That's cap.
For trying to sell an NFT with very low value will be trying.
No, because in these old Jordans, if you go to eBay, there's a market for this. There's a market for this. Niggas constantly get old Jordans and redo them. Selling the NFT with no volume. It's like going outside and trying to sell a pair of your old ass drawers to anybody walking by. Hey, I got these boxers, man. Like, man, I got these boxers. Don't nobody want them bitch ass boxers. So you just holding on to them bitches. You just holding on to them bitches. Hey, bro, you sure you don't want to buy it? 6 months go by. Ain't nobody still buy them weak ass drawers because nobody want them bitches. So all these niggas with this shit, there are people listing this NFT for sale to this day. Let's go to look, this bitch is for sale. This is for sale. When did they list this? They listed this shit 3 months ago. He listed this bitch for 3 months and it ain't selling 3 months. And it ain't sell in 3 months. Matter of fact, yo, since it ain't sell, he took it down 8 days ago and put it up for 0.01 because he can't even get 0.06 Ethereum. Hey, bitch, it's not selling. A dead project. This nigga put up for 0.03, couldn't get that, took it down 8 days. Can't get it. 3 months, no sale. No sale. That nigga, this is a total fucking scam. He hasn't tweeted since January. How do you do this to niggas that fuck with you? I never can understand. How you straight up scam niggas that fuck with you? I can never. Bro, if you start a car dealership and if you selling your cars for fucking, let's say for example, you selling your cars for $100,000. I wouldn't say nothing to you. If you selling niggas legit cars that work, hey, that's on them for buying that car for $100,000. That's what they want to do. But if you selling a car for $100,000 and that bitch ain't got no engine in it, you're scamming, and that's a problem. Nigga, you sold niggas an NFT that you ain't do shit with. You sold niggas some clothes that they you ain't even shipped to them. Who's scamming? Oprah Side. That nigga is scamming. That's nuts.
Some very old used Jordans. The person you're selling it to will either laugh at you for trying to sell them some dirty ass shoes or buy them to restore them. But when it comes to NFTs, no one is buying one that has a dead community behind
hell no.
It's a complete rug pull in an attempt to restore it. That would be very foolish to do. After Danger Rangers failed, people started accusing someone named Vulcan, I'm guessing it's somebody who works close to OSN on a project, of scamming people with fake giveaways, and in Clark's words, painted him as the bad guy for spending 1/5 of the profits on a mutant ape yacht club NFT. This wasn't the only NFT that Clark used the money he made from the project on, as he spent money on another NFT called Clone X. So much for using the funds for endangered species. These were not the only things he purchased with the money that he scammed from his project, but I'll get into that later. In early February, OSN went live to give an apology that he really thought people would buy. I'll let you just listen to this BS.
I spent 6 months working on that project, man.
I'm not surprised by it.
I gave it everything I had. You know, I sold every chain, every watch. I spent.
You gave this everything you had. What's this? What's this? Oh my God, nigga, GG. The GG, nigga, he bought so many. Keep seeing this nigga name. All right, but you gave this everything you had. Nigga, you went to Fiverr and you got niggas to draw you NFTs. There's no way this is everything you had. Look at the chart on this shit. Go all time. The activity. This shit went from 145 sales to 4 sales a month later. 1 sale over here, and they only got like, in all these months, it's been, what's this, one sale in all of these months. This nigga's sick.
Spent over $150,000 to get that project out. And I appreciate everybody that supported me. It unfortunately didn't go the way I wanted it to go.
You know, nigga, I'm not finna scam niggas. Cut that cap. NFTs. Shout out to the 500 in the motherfucking chat.
Man, and it took so much out of me, bro. Like, you guys might not believe me, but I swear to God, it took so much out of me, bro. Like, it was the most money I ever made in a day, but I swear I wasn't f***ing happy, bro. I was f***ing crying, bro.
Jordan's 300 just subscribed.
I
was f***ing blue, bro. I was f***ing blue, you know? I felt like f***ing Josh Allen. That's why I was posting that shit on my story, bro. I felt like I did everything I f***ing could, bro. Everything I f***ing could, bro. And I f***ing lost, you know? I was f***ing going through it. I'm honestly still...
Dude, this look like a nigga that... that lost it all, bro?
Going through it, you know? I don't want anybody to have any negative energy or to be mad at me, bro, because I swear to God on my dead grandma, I did everything I f***ing could.
That nigga lying on granny, man. That's wicked, bro. Lying on granny is crazy.
I did everything I f***ing could.
CJ So Cool vibes. What the fuck CJ So Cool did?
There's nothing I could have done that I didn't do. People were asking me, how did I get so many projects to collab with me? Because I f***ing DM'd 400 projects. Like, there's nothing more I literally could have done physically, mentally.
But my thing is, no bullshit. Let me level with him. Let me level with him on this NFT project and say that, yo, this is everything that you could, that he did everything that he could have did. I'm gonna level with you.
I would like to announce Oprah as the new captain of the Washington Capitals.
Hey, five, appreciate you for the goddamn dollar sub. I'm appreciate you for the dono. Hey, no bullshit. Hey, let me level with you and say, I was saying you did everything that you could. Let me say that I believe you. Why would you push this fucking NFT so heavy and not see the, and not look at their roadmap and not see what they had planned for the NFT? Why would you bring this to your viewer, your average viewer, and push it so heavy as if this is something that can that they can gain from in the long term, and you don't see, oh, what's y'all plans for down the road? Oh, y'all see I have utility? How are y'all going to do this? How are y'all going to do that? What are y'all going to do to make sure that the NFT continue to go? Why would you not look at that? Come on, my nigga.
Financially, you know? So, anyways, I say that to say, I know there's some people that still have not gotten their clothes. I'm going to just come clean with you guys. What happened was, I spent a lot of, like I said, man, I spent $150,000 on it.
So you spent other niggas' money. You spent money for shit that wasn't even fulfilled on some bullshit dolphin pics. On some bullshit dolphin pics, my nigga.
This nigga Ozzy did wilt numbers with the amount of scamming he did. Nigga. At least Soulja Boy gave niggas them fake Xboxes when he did his scamming.
At least niggas can play bullshit games. At least niggas play. This nigga spent money from on day clothes on a gorilla with a Pusheisty mask. Fuck up, guapo. Nigga got lettuce on his chest. Niggas put they clothes on a Native American leopard. Fuck is these he got on? Beats by Dre? This nigga scammed them. Them niggas ain't even get they clothes, bruh. Them niggas ain't get they clothes, bruh. And he over here dropping NFTs with motherfuckers wearing Little Red Riding Hood shirt. And this nigga got on a goddamn Cinco de Mayo hat. Nigga nigga been holding this motherfucker NFT for 6 months. My God. This fake ass Dior shirt this bitch got on, bro. It been, yo, the nigga got the nerve to, yo, the shirt says hold on. Boy, you is sick. Boy, you are a scammer. My boy. My boy. Boy, boy, boy. This shit wicked. Look at these NFTs, bro. This shit is ass. RP to all the fallen soldiers and $8, man. Y'all never getting that back. Y'all never getting that back. You hear me? Never.
Bro, I spent a lot of money on this shit. Now everybody that doesn't get that doesn't have.
What is you doing, nigga? I was scrolling on the NFTs, nigga. Be patient.
This shit. Calm down. Relax. It's being made right now. You're going to get your stuff. You know, I'm super sorry for the delay. One positive lining, though, is that I did set myself up so that in the future, when I drop my next season, oh my God, it's going to be the craziest shit I've ever fucking done. For sure. But I'm really,
I'm
really sorry to everybody that still hasn't gotten the shit.
Oh my God.
And, yeah, bro, I just want to come on here and just be as authentic as possible, you know, and just say sorry, you know. I was trying to be great. I was trying to be great, bro. I was trying to be great. I don't know what to say. I tried to be great and it didn't work.
Shout out to my boy Button on Twitter for all this information on the NFT stuff. I had a slight idea about what happened with the whole NFT
stuff. That's crazy.
OSN, but if it wasn't for him,
this nigga make none of the fucking clothes.
For what he said. Because this is crazy. It's ridiculous. But shout out to Button Old. I don't know what kind of name that is, but shout out to my mans. Shout out to him. Make sure y'all go follow him. Okay, so in one of these screenshots, OSN claims that he spent more than $200,000 on his project. And that he actually admits to buying both of these NFTs, saying that it's nothing to hide or whatever like that. If you go to both of his profiles that he has on OpenSea, there's two profiles that he uses that you can see of the NFTs that he bought.
I don't give a fuck. I made the most money I ever made on what he said. I ever made what I ever made on day, man. Whatever. That nigga say, we didn't have the success I wanted, and this shit hurts me more than anything. Shut the fuck up. You are lying. You made the most money you ever made. Damn, I'm sick. Damn, that shit hurt. But them racks. Them racks. But damn, that shit hurt, man. Boy, you full of shit.
But I have a screenshot of around this time because he sent some of these NFTs to somebody else or something at this point. He only has one in that account. But at the time of this, he had these NFTs in his account that he spent money or that he bought. And, you know, it's clear proof. Clear proof that he really bought these. He spent money on these from the proceeds of whatever he got from his NFT project. And look what he says in here. He says, nobody on my team spent a dollar, especially not Vulcan in Turkey. So Vulcan is from Turkey.
My but nigga put funded, both of his NFT accounts a Fargo W investigator work. W investigator work, man. That nigga put both of this nigga open season this bitch. My God. The nigga bought a mutant ape. He took the money that he got from them niggas and bought a NFT that's actually doing something. My God. This nigga is sick. That shit is wicked, boy. All right. Anywho.
By me. So if I want to buy something after selling my $80,000 watch, then God damn it, I will. And I'll have to explain myself to anyone in that regard. That's why I posted it. I had nothing to hide. Remember I said that wasn't the only thing that Clark purchased? He actually purchased a watch too. And he admitted to it. That's crazy. And he actually posted this on Instagram. He posted, oh, what should I get? Is this looking good? Like, are you serious? Like, no shame at all that he just took all these people's money and just deleted the Discord after, too. So, like I said, he deleted the Discord and he went shopping to buy a watch from what I'm guessing was the funds that he was supposed to.
That watch look expensive than the motherfucker, too, bro. Hey, let me tell you what. Jewelry is expensive. It's expensive to make. It's expensive to make and it's damn sure expensive to buy. This nigga finessed them niggas out there, motherfucking money. Guapo, I'm not doing you no favor. I'm not getting up and getting that poster.
To be given to charity. So these funds were supposed to be given to an endangered species charity, whatever choice of the community. So the community was going to choose.
That nigga
charity,
said, fuck them endangered species, nigga. Bitch, these diamonds endangered. And he bought the diamonds. Ethereum
addresses to hide it, which he really didn't because I figured it out very easily. On March 8th, 2022, a month after all of this, he purchased a brand new $30,000 Rolls Royce Wraith. That same month, he went to like an NBA game and did all this other stuff and was going watch shopping again, this time for Richard Mille's.
That so nigga looking at Richard Mille's, my God!
Where you got that Richard Mille money from? Because you wasn't talking Richard Mille's a few months ago. You definitely wasn't talking Richard Mille's. This is crazy.
Bro, them bitches clean too.
NFT, and my I can't sit God. Here and people can't sit here and call me crazy about this. You know what I mean? Like, how do you just automatically get money from Richard Mille? You're a YouTuber, one. Two.
It's YouTubers out here that's making money, that's making enough money for Richard Mille's. I believe that OSN, honestly, bro, you know what's crazy? OSN, I'm not the pocket watch gang. Honestly, real shit. Like I said, before the thing, I ain't never have nothing against OSN. OSN make enough money to be able to afford Richard Mille from YouTube. He do. OSN go crazy with the views, bro. That nigga makes enough money. You make enough money.
Like, yeah, I guess you probably make some good passive income. Your channel not booming like it used to be. Oh, Richard Mille? Like, bro, come on. You not fooling anyone, bro. I really don't understand.
How much some Richard Mille's go for? And the thing is, the reason why I say he make enough money to do it is because how long he been doing it. It's honestly because of how long he's been doing it. Them bitches expensive as fuck, my God. Meal? Jesus Christ. That nigga dropped a bag on that bitch. And that bitch Plain Jane, he dropped a bag on that bitch, but my God. Six figures? Yeah, you can get one for under a mil. But you spending at least six figures on that bitch. Hold on, let me see. Look at these watches, boy. Lord have mercy. Get me out of here, bro. I'm itching. This shit's too expensive.
Understand how someone can really just outright scam the people that got them to where they are today. Like, it makes no sense to me. To Oprahside, Clark, or whatever you want to be called, without millions of people, you would not be here.
Playing worth more. Please believe I know.
You are in the position that you're in today. Think about that.
Honestly, get your broke ass off this.
Without millions of people, there would be no Oprah side.
Fuck up, Guapo.
People affected by these actions, it's nothing wrong with accepting this as a loss and just moving on. But what's wrong is just accepting this and not spreading the word about
That's
it.
A fact.
If this video was helpful to you or you enjoyed it, make sure you like the video up, spam the comments, you know, share it to everybody.
W video.
Tag Keemstar in my
W video. W video. Fuck Keemstar, nigga. Fuck Keemstar, but W video.
Just do all that for me, man, because I'm just trying to help everybody out who got scammed in this situation or wronged in the situation. And that's all I got for
that
y'all.
Shit crazy, bro.
I'll see y'all in the next video with a regular style video, but this is just something different that I really felt like I had to do. Sorry if I just hit the mic.
Fargo, good video, bro. I think he had like a response to this shit or some shit like that. What nigga channel is it? Shit, 28 minutes. I don't know if I'm gonna
do it.
He wants to sue me. Wait, OSN responded to him? I don't know if I'm gonna watch this whole thing. Who knows? I ain't gonna lie. I'm gonna be live for a little while. So, but we just watched this video and it was 32 minutes. I ain't gonna do that. Crazy King slander? Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. I'm not a fan of Keemstar at all. At all. At all. Niggas are racist. Once a racist, always a racist. Anywho. I'm not watching Meat Canyon.